Welcome! In today's video, I'll go over the four dopamine pathways: mesolimbic, mesocortical, tuberoinfundibular, and last but not least, nigrostriatal pathway. When we give antipsychotics to patients, what does it do? It decreases the dopamine. And when we decrease the dopamine, it affects all of the pathways. First pathway is mesolimbic pathway. It regulates emotional behavior. Dopamine travels from the VTA, which is the yellow dot, to the nucleus accumbens, which is the blue dot. In patients with psychosis or schizophrenia, there is too much dopamine taking place. There's too much dopamine going from the VTA to the NA. And this is when you see these patients present with positive symptoms. What are the positive symptoms? The positive symptoms are hallucinations, delusions. They are the patients that have referential thinking. They have disorganized behavior, grandiosity. So how do we treat these patients? We give these patients antipsychotics. And when we give these patients antipsychotics, remember what I had said earlier, it decreases dopamine. Now, when we decrease the dopamine level by giving the antipsychotic, not only affects mesolimbic, it's going to affect, remember, all the other pathways. So let's see how it affects mesocortical pathway. Mesocortical pathway is known for cognition and executive functioning. And dopamine travels from here, the VTA, which is the yellow dot again, to the cortex. So cortex, associate cortex with the cortical pathway. Cortex, cortical, cortical pathway. And in patients with schizophrenia or psychosis, there's too little dopamine, so there's not enough dopamine reaching to the cortex, and this is when you see these patients have negative symptoms. What are the negative symptoms? Negative symptoms like affective flattening, poverty of speech, avolition, or apathy. These are the negative symptoms that you would see in mesocortical pathway. Remember, cortical pathway, outside cortex, negative symptoms. Great. How do we go about treating these patients? We give these patients antipsychotics. And when we give these patients antipsychotics, it ends up decreasing the dopamine that's already decreased in patients with schizophrenia and psychosis. This leads us to our third pathway called nigrostriatal pathway. Now, this pathway is known to have motor control. This is a pathway where dopamine travels from substantia nigra to the striatum, which is made up of caudate and putamen. In psychosis or schizophrenia, there is too little dopamine traveling from the substantia nigra to the striatum, and this is where you risk EPS symptoms, EPS symptoms like Parkinson's symptoms. So when we give an antipsychotic, this is decreasing the dopamine even more, and therefore it induces Parkinson's symptoms. Now, last but not least, the fourth pathway is called tuberoinfundibular pathway. This is a pathway that prolactin is secreted. This is a pathway where dopamine goes from hypothalamus to the pituitary gland. Hypothalamus is noted in the orange dot, and pituitary gland is noted in the pink dot. Whenever there is an increase in dopamine, note that there will always be a decrease in prolactin level. And when you see a decrease in the dopamine, this is going to increase your prolactin level. And when there's an increase in prolactin, this is going to cause amenorrhea and galactorrhea. In this pathway, you might see a patient experiencing varying levels of growth in one breast or possibly both of their breasts. In some rare cases, you might see the patient complain of discharge of breast milk as well. So remember, antipsychotics, it decreases dopamine level. In the mesolimbic pathway, note the positive symptoms are in the middle of the brain, positive inside, negative outside. Positive symptoms in the middle of the brain, and when we give antipsychotics, you're going to improve these positive symptoms. In the mesocortical pathway, think of cortex. This is where you would see the negative symptoms, outside, negative, outside, cortical, cortex. This is the pathway when you give the antipsychotic, it's going to exacerbate the negative symptoms. In the nigrostriatal pathway, when you give the antipsychotic, you're risking the patient for the EPS. This is where you're seeing the Parkinsonian symptoms, dystonia, things of that nature. Tuberoinfundibular pathway, think prolactin secretion. This is when you're risking for amenorrhea and galactorrhea. So guys, this brings us to the very end. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment below. Let me know what videos you guys would like for me to do next. Comment below and also let me know what you've learned. I would love to hear from you.